Hello children, welcome to the class. How are you all? I hope you are fine and good. I am Dakshaini, handling biology from Bharadasanar Metric Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. Children, today we are going to see 11th standard botany, the second chapter. What is the name of the chapter, children? Plant Kingdom, right? So far in this chapter, we have discussed about some of the various classes of the plant kingdom. In the first class, we discussed about the algae and its characteristics, later bryophytes, and in the previous session, we discussed about the pterophytes and the steel, types of steel. So, what is the steel? Yes, steel is the central portion of a root or a stem which consists of the vascular bundles. Yes, very good. And we have discussed about the various types of steels and how, in which plant they are present. And we have seen some examples of different types of steels. And in this session, we are going to study about the gymnosperms. What are gymnosperms, right? So, these are all the plants which see here, the coniferous forest, cycas, pinus, all comes under the gymnosperms. So, what do you see from this picture, children? The seeds of the plant, you can see with your naked eyes. Yes. So, in Greek, gymnos. In Greek, gymnos means naked. Gymnos means naked. Naked means which we can see with our normal eyes. No need to view the seeds. For example, in some plants, angiosperms and all, we have to look the seeds or the ovules through the microscope only. But in the gymnosperms, the seeds are naked. And sperms refers to, in Greek, sperms means seed. Sperms means seed. So, the word gymnosperms means naked seeds. And in this session, we are going to study about the plants which produces the naked seeds. Right? Example, Casuarina also, Savukumaram we say in Tamil, right? They also possess the naked seeds which we can see through our normal eyes. And these gymnosperms are abundant during the Mesozoic era. Mesozoic era, and especially in the two periods, one is the Jurassic period. Jurassic period and the another period as a Cretaceous period. Cretaceous period. So, these two are important one more question, children. So, gymnos means naked, and we can see these plants abundantly. They were present mostly abundantly during the Jurassic period. Yes. Now, I want to ask you some question. Have you all seen the Jurassic Park film, children? Yes. And it is a Michael Crichton's science fiction, right? It is a book written by Michael, and it was later taken as a film by Steven Spielberg as Jurassic Park. And in that movie, you can see some insects are preserved in the some substances, right? So, that substance we call it as a amber. Just look into this. What is this, children? It is a amber. A-M-B-E-R. Right? So, amber, it is not degradable and it is the secretion of the plant. So, what is the connection between the gymnosperms and the amber? Yes, very good. This amber, this is a substance produced from the gymnosperm plants. For example, unga veetu kitta murunga maram irukum, right? You can see some jelly like substance secreting from that in badam tree or in a drumstick tree. You can see pisin, what we say in Tamil, children. Piscine. Likewise, the gymnosperms also produce some gelatinous substance that we call it as a amber. Just look into this, the insect is preserved in the amber. And now let us see what is amber. It is a gymnospermic plant, and you can see, children, some secretions are coming out of the bark of the tree. So, the name of this plant is Pinus. Pinus sassinifera. Pinus sassinifera. And the gelatinous substance produced from this plant is, we call it as a amber. And it is not degraded easily, and in the previous years, previous period, it was stored to preserve the insects. The other uses of amber is that some jewelries are made out of amber. So we learned what is amber, and this plants are abundant during the Jurassic period. So now we are going to see about the general characteristic features of the gymnosperms. What are the three types of plants you see here, children? Yes, some plants are woody. Yes, some gymnosperms are woody. Some gymnosperms occur as shrubs. What do you mean by shrubs? Pudar. So some are shrubs. Mostly the shrubs we grow as ornamental plants. Another type is lianas. L-I-A-N-A. What do you mean by liana, children? Liana, see, look at this. This is a liana, right? It is a small vein, kodi. We say it is a kodi, right? So, this some gymnosperms are like lianas. And this we can see in a plant, gnetum. G-N-U, G-N-E-T-U-M, gnetum. It is a type of gymnosperms which appears in the shape of the lianas. The lianas are rooted, but they climb other trees for the photosynthesis, right? So these lianas are rooted, but it depends on the other plant for it for climbing. So we have studied about the three types of gymnosperms. Some are woody, some are shrubs, and some are lianas. And next we are going to study about the another characteristics. And these gymnosperms, the majority phase is sporophyte, and they possesses the root, stem, and leaves. And now we are going to study about the roots. What is the name of this plant, children? It is a cycas. It is a cycas. And this is a root of the cycas. There are roots of the cycas. We say it as a coralloid roots. Coralloid roots. Coralloid roots. But in the roots, there we can see the symbiotic association of blue-green algae, right? In the roots, some blue-green algae are present which help in nitrogen fixation of the soil. So, that blue-green algae and the coralloid roots are in mutual relationship with each other, right? For example, the cyanobacteria gets nutrition from the, get the shelter from the coralloid roots. Likewise, the cyanobacteria helps in fixing nitrogen to the coralloid roots. So it is in symbiotic association. The another example is a pinus. This is a pine tree, children. It is a pinus, and it is the roots of the pinus. And what do you see here, children? You can see some whitey structure like fungus on the roots, right? So that we say it as a mycorrhizae. Mycorrhizae. So this is also a symbiotic association, that the root is benefited from the mycorrhizae, and same way the mycorrhizae receives some benefits from the plant. So we discussed about the two types of roots. One is in the cycas, coralloid roots. What is present? Cyanobacteria. And in the roots of pinus, what is present? Mycorrhizae. And stem or aerial. Right, next we can see about the stem. Some are aerial. Aerial means what? It is found above the ground, and some are branched, some are unbranched. And here, what is this, children? The plant is very tall, right? So we can say this shoots are of long shoot, and it is a coniferous trees. Coniferous is also an example for the gymnosperms. It is a coniferous plant with a long shoot, and it is a type of conifers with a dwarf shoot. Dwarf means what? Very short. So this plant is an example for dwarf shoot. Dwarf shoot. So we discussed about the shoot, that is a stem. The next character we are going to discuss is about the leaves. About the leaves. The leaves are of two types. For example, this is a pinus plant, children. Here you can see two types of leaves. One is a scale leaves. These brown shaped structures, we say it as a scale leaves. And the green structures, we say it as a foliage leaves. What is the difference between foliage leaf and scale leaves. It's not given in your book, children. Just listen. So foliage leaves or scale leaves are brown in color. Scale leaves are brown in color, and their main function is protection. What is their main function? Their main function is protection, right? Likewise, what is the function of the foliage leaves? The foliage leaves are green in color. The foliage leaves are green in color, and what is the main function? They possess the chlorophyll, so photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. And one more difference is that the scale leaves are short-lived, but the foliage leaves are long-lived. So this is a difference between the scale leaf and the foliage leaf. Since it has two types of leaf, what is the condition we call? We can say the condition as dimorphic. Dimorphic. Di means two, morphic means appearance. Since the leaves are in two different varieties, we can say them as dimorphic leaves. And next we discussed about the roots, stem and the leaves, and now we are going to study about the vascular tissues present. And most of the gymnosperms possess tracheids, right? But there is an exception, except two plants, right? Many of them possess the tracheids. The plants which possess the vessels, that is the xylem and the phloem, are these two plants. Now, what is the name of this plant, children? The plant name is gnetum. The plant name is gnetum. It is a generic and it is of many subspecies. So, gnetum. And what is the name of this plant? Ephedra. Ephedra. So, these two plants possesses the xylem, that is the vessels, that is the xylem and the phloem. What is the role of xylem? Transportation or conduction of water and minerals. What is the function of phloem? Yes, conduction of food. And now we are going to see about the wood. Secondary growth is seen, and we have discussed that some trees of the gymnosperms are woody. So they possess two types of wood. One is a manocyclic and another one is a pycnocyclic. What do you mean by magnocyclic? The magnocyclic leaves wood is porous. Porous means what? Soft. Yes, pores means there are many spaces are present, right? In the wood you can see many pores, pore like substances. So here, this due to this pores, the wood is very soft. Wood is very soft. And here what is present? Medullary rays or wide. Medullary rays is nothing. If the plant has a, for example, if you take a steel, the vascular bundle is present here, right? So the place, the space between the vascular bundle, we say it as a medullary rays. Here the manocyclic wood possess the wide medullary rays. Wide medullary rays. And next we are going to study about the pycnocyclic wood. Just opposite to this, the pycnocyclic wood is compact. What do you mean by compact? Compact means tightly packed. Compact, and it has a narrow medullary rays. Here wide, but here the medullary ray is narrow. Narrow medullary rays. And now the example for the wood, the manocyclic wood is a cycas. What is the example for the manocyclic wood, children? Cycas plant. And the example for pycnocyclic is pinus. So this is the main difference between the manocyclic and the pycnocyclic wood. And now we are going to study about the spores, that is about the reproduction. It is said to be heterosporous. Hetero means what? Different. So different types of spores are produced. And here the first condition is that monoecious. monoecious. What do you mean by monoecious? Monoecious means single house, right? Both male and the female cones are present in the single plant. So that some types of gymnosperms are monoecious and some are dioecious. What do you mean by dioecious? Dioecious means double house. That is, the male and the female cones are present on the different plants. So, reproduction, some plants are monoecious and some plants are dioecious. And I told you there are two types of spores. So, the first one, and the plant bears two types of, it is a monoecious plant and it bears a male and the female part on the single plant. Here, the male gamete is a microsporangium. Microsporangium. Likewise, the female, it's a female cone. The female gamete is a megasporangium. Megasporangium. Yes? So, the microsporangium produces the male gamete and then the megasporangium produces more ovules. So, fertilization takes place between the male gamete and the female gamete and results in the formation of the zygote. Next, we are going to see some other characteristics, and these gymnosperms exhibit anemophilous pollination. What do you mean by anemophilous? Anemophilous means wind. Anemophily means a pollination by wind. Wind pollination takes place. Wind pollination takes place in the gymnosperms. Wind pollination takes place. So, the wind pollinated flowers, we say it as a anemophilous flowers. And next one is a siphonogamous fertilization. What do you mean by siphonogamous? Siphonogamous means the fertilization takes place through the pollen tube. Pollen tube. That is a pollen grain. Pollen grain produces the pollen tube, and from in this what is present? The male gametes are present. Through the pollen tube, the male gametes are transferred to the ovule of the female. So, what type of fertilization? Siphonogamous fertilization. Here, polyembryony is seen. What do you mean by poly? Poly means many embryos. So, many embryos are formed. As a result of fusion of male and female, seed is produced, right? So, many embryos, that is the endosperms. Many endosperms. Endosperms, how it is formed, children? By the fusion of secondary nucleus and the male gamete. So, this endosperms develop before fertilization. From this, the one more question is asked, children. Before fertilization, the endosperms starts to develop. And alternation of generation. What do you mean by alternation of generation? So, it undergoes two types of generation. One is a gametophytic phase. And the another one is a sporophytic phase. So, which is dominant here? Yes, very good. And previously we studied the gymnosperms are haplodiplontic. And what is dominant? Sporophyte phase is dominant. In its life cycle, the majority phase is sporophyte. And the gametophyte is responsible for only producing the gametes. Next, we are going to see about the classification of gymnosperms. The person named Spohn. Spohn in the year 1965. Spohn classified the gymnosperms into three classes, nine orders and 31 families. It's an important neat question, children. 31 families, right? So this is about the classification of the gymnosperms. You may ask, ma'am, why should I know about the gymnosperms, right? So gymnosperms are very helpful for us in our day-to-day life. That is, some plants are woody, no? So that with the help of that we can make the furnitures. And turpentine, you all know turpentine, right? We used to apply on the woods. That is also obtained from the gymnosperms plants. And sago. Sago means javvarsi. It is also obtained from this gymnosperms only. So by growing the gymnosperms, it is very economically useful to us. We can earn more money also. Who are all interested in horticulture, they may grow the gymnosperms plants. So far in this session, we discussed about the gymnosperms. What is gymnosperm, children? Naked seeds. The plants in which the seeds are naked, we say it as gymnosperms. And then we discuss some of the characteristics of the gymnosperms. We discussed about their root, stem and the leaves, and then we discussed about their types of wood also, and we have seen many examples of the gymnosperms. And the person who classified the gymnosperms, children? Spohn. Yes, very good. And this is the assessment related to this topic. Just I will ask you one question from it. A plant secretion that is efficient preservative is what? First we discussed about the amber. Yes, very good. So amber is the answer. So like this, many questions are related to this topic. So children, with this session comes to an end. In the description, we have attached the study material, assessment and question bank for this lesson. Go through it, practice the diagrams, write all the scientific names and note, see the images of all the plants. Thank you children, have a nice day.